Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel, Sparkle English, where I teach you different ways that you can improve your level of English. Today's video is a part of my English Writing Essentials series. I've linked in the description below to my playlist on all the different videos I have so far in this series, including how to use colons, apostrophes, quotation marks, capitalization rules, and more. Today's video is on how to use semicolons. So let's get started. In this lesson, you will learn how to use semicolons correctly when writing in English. This right here is a colon, and this is a semicolon. You can see in the description below, I have linked you to a video on how to use colons, but today we're going to talk all about how to use semicolons. Semicolons are kind of like hybrids between periods or full stops and commas. We use semicolons to join two closely related independent clauses in more complex lists with punctuation and between independent clauses that are linked with conjunctive adverbs. Now, I know this sounds very confusing and very complicated, but don't worry because in this video, I'm going to break down rule by rule how to use semicolons, and I promise you that at the end of this video you will understand all the different uses of when we use semicolons. So the first rule is that we can use a semicolon between closely related independent clauses which are not joined by a coordinating conjunction. So we use semicolons between two complete sentences which are not already linked by words like and, but, or, nor, for, so, and yet. So here are three different examples of how we could write these sentences. Let's look at the first example. I'm going to order fish. He is going to order steak. So here we have two different independent clauses that are closely related. In this first example, we have ended the sentence with a period and then started a new sentence with a capital H for he. And this is correct. We could also connect these two sentences by using a conjunction. So in the second example, I'm going to order fish and he is going to order steak. That is also correct. Now the third example, we're going to use a semicolon to connect these two sentences because they're very closely related. I'm going to order fish, semicolon. And you can see the semicolon is directly connected to the H. We don't put a space. I'm going to order fish. Right after the H, we put the semicolon. Then we put a space. And then he is going to order steak. You can see here that we have not capitalized the H in he because we're making this one complete sentence using a semicolon. So we do not capitalize the first letter unless, of course, this word was a proper noun or a word that is always capitalized. So because these two sentences are closely related, we can combine them using a semicolon. I'm going to order fish. He is going to order steak. So let's look at some more examples following this. I don't really like dessert, semicolon. I prefer savory foods. Again, these two sentences are directly related or closely related, so we can use a semicolon. Mom has gone shopping, semicolon. Dad's still at work. Now here, we are only capitalizing the D in dad because we're using dad like it's a name. If you said, he's still at work, you would put it like a small h, a lowercase h, he's still at work, okay? But we're using a semicolon because again, these two independent clauses are closely related. My sister is a party planner. My brother is a photographer. Call me tomorrow. I'll let you know my decision then, okay? So all of these independent clauses are closely related, so we can connect them using a semicolon. Again, you could also make these into two separate sentences by putting a period and then a capital letter but a semicolon is also an option when they are closely related sentences. So let's look at rule two. Rule two, we use semicolons between independent clauses joined by a conjunctive adverb. Maybe you're wondering, what is a conjunctive adverb? Well, don't worry, I'm going to explain that now. So you should use a semicolon when you have a conjunctive adverb linking two independent clauses. Some common conjunctive adverbs include moreover, nevertheless, however, otherwise, therefore, then, finally, likewise, and consequently. Okay? So let's look at an example. I can come to your party tomorrow, period. However, I will arrive late. Because these two independent clauses are closely related, we can, again, join them using a semicolon. I can come to your party tomorrow, semicolon. However, comma, I will arrive late. You cannot just put a comma here. You can't put, I can come to your party tomorrow, comma, however, comma, I will arrive late. You have to put a semicolon. You can either split this into two different sentences, like this first example, or in the second example, you put a semicolon, and then you connect it using the semicolon with the second independent clause. Let's look at some more examples following this. I have meetings all day tomorrow, semicolon. Otherwise, comma, I would come for lunch. Again, otherwise is a conjunctive adverb. He was very tired, semicolon. Nevertheless, comma, he went on walking. Lauren just got married, semicolon. Meanwhile, comma, I am still single. Susan studied hard for her English exam, semicolon. Therefore, comma, she got an excellent grade. So again, all of these are conjunctive adverbs that are joining these two independent clauses, otherwise, nevertheless, meanwhile, and therefore. And when we use these conjunctive adverbs, we have to use a semicolon before to connect them. You can't just put a comma, a double comma. You can't do that, okay? You can either split this into two different sentences, or you can use a semicolon and connect the two sentences together. So let's look at rule three. We use semicolons between items in a series containing internal punctuation. So semicolons are occasionally used like they're fancy commas, okay? We use semicolons to divide the items of a list if the items are long or contain internal punctuation. The semicolons help readers keep track of the divisions between the items in the list. So normally when we have a list, we would use a comma. For example, I went shopping and I bought bread, comma, cheese, comma, and coffee. Okay? We would use commas to separate the items in the list. So if we look at this first example here, I traveled to Spain, Italy, and France last year. Here we put commas to separate each country, Spain, Italy, and France. Now, what if I wanted to list the cities and the countries? This would be incorrect. I traveled to Madrid, comma, Spain, comma, Rome, comma, Italy, comma, and Paris, comma, France last year. This would be incorrect because say someone didn't know that Paris was in France or Rome was in Italy. This would almost sound like you were saying you went to six different places. I traveled to Madrid and Spain and Rome and Italy and Paris and France. And that doesn't make sense because Madrid is in Spain. That's just one place, Madrid, Spain, Rome, Italy. Because there's already punctuation in this list, we have to use a semicolon to separate these into groups. So this is what would be correct. I traveled to Madrid, comma, Spain, then we'd put a semicolon because that would separate this into one little group. I traveled to Madrid, Spain, semicolon. Rome, comma, Italy, semicolon. And Paris, France, last year. And that makes it easy for the reader to understand this is three places, Madrid, Spain, Rome, Italy, and Paris, France. So we would only put the semicolons after the first two or more if the list was four or five. This is only a list of three, so we only have to put it after the first two before the conjunction, okay? Let's look at some more examples. So this first one, we just did this example. So let's look at this second example. The company invited Steve, Carl, and Ryan to the conference. This would be correct because this is clearly three different people, Steve, Carl, and Ryan. But what if we had a more complicated list that already had punctuation, it already had commas, and we wanted to give more information about the people in the list? The company invited Steve, the accountant, Carl, the office manager, and Ryan, the bookkeeper, to the conference. If we only use commas, again, it sounds like we're inviting five or six different people. The company invited Steve and the accountant and Carl and the office manager and Ryan and the bookkeeper to the conference. But we don't want to do that. We want it to be clear that Steve is the accountant, that Carl is the office manager, that this is only three different people. So we have to use semicolons. The company invited Steve, the accountant. This semicolon makes it clear that Steve is the name of the accountant that's being invited. He is the accountant. This is one person. Carl, the office manager, semicolon. Again, that makes it clear that Carl is the office manager. And Ryan, comma, the bookkeeper, to the conference. Okay? And that, again, the semicolons make it clear that this is one, two, three different people that are being invited to the conference, not six, five or six different people. Okay, so now that we have studied the three different rules of using semicolons, we are ready to start practicing. I have five different sentences here that all require semicolons, so your job is to put the semicolons in these sentences. I recommend you write your answers in the comment section and see if you're correct, or just get a piece of paper and write down on your piece of paper what your answers are for 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So first I'm going to read you all five sentences, and then I want you to answer them and think about where semicolons should go. If you need any help, go back in the video and watch again, or skip through until you find the answer, and then come back and try to use the information you just learned. Okay, so I'm going to read you through all five sentences first. Number one, Jack is studying economics. Ruth is studying law. Number two, I'm not feeling very well, therefore I won't be able to come tonight. Number three, let's chat tomorrow. I'll message you in the morning. Number four, the newest project members are Tony Thomas, intern, Karen Davis, staff manager, and Lee Smith, project director. Number five, I don't like eating most desserts. However, I do love ice cream. Okay, so pause this video and think about your answers. And if you're ready, let's get started and I'm going to give you the answers. So the first one is quite easy. Jack is studying economics. That is an independent clause that's closely related to the next independent clause, which is Ruth is studying law. So we're going to put a semicolon right after economics. Jack is studying economics, semicolon, Ruth is studying law. I'm not feeling very well, semicolon, right after the L. Therefore, I won't be able to come tonight. Therefore is a conjunctive adverb. So we have to put a semicolon right after well to connect these two. We can't just put another comma. Let's chat tomorrow. I'll message you in the morning. Again, These are two different independent clauses that are closely related. So we're going to put semicolon right after tomorrow. Let's chat tomorrow, semicolon. I'll message you in the morning. Now, number four is the most difficult of all five. Here, we have three different newest project members: Tony Thomas, Karen Davis, and Lee Smith. And these are their titles. Tony Thomas is an intern, Karen Davis is a staff manager, and Lee Smith is a project director. So we have to put semicolons in this list because otherwise it seems like we're talking about five or six different people. So the newest project members are Tony Thomas, intern. So we're going to put the semicolon right after the N because Tony Thomas is an intern. So Tony Thomas, intern. Karen Davis, staff manager. So here we're going to put the semicolon right after manager. And Lee Smith, project director. And that has divided this now into three different groups. Tony Thomas, intern. Karen Davis, staff manager. And Lee Smith, project director. So now it is clear to the readers that these are three different people and not five or six different people. And the last one, again, we have a conjunctive adverb here, however. I don't like eating most desserts. Semicolon. However, I do love ice cream. Okay, so you did it. Let me know in the comments section how many you got correct. The more you practice using semicolons, the easier it will become. I hope that this video made sense to you and that now you have a better understanding of how to use semicolons when you're writing in English. Make sure to check out my other videos in my English Writing Essentials series. And if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to Sparkle English for more videos on learning English, on improving your level of English, so you can become a better writer, a better speaker, and become more confident in your abilities when you're writing in English. Thanks again for watching, and I will see you in my next video.